Hey everybody, today we're going to do a lesson on data handling. And this is when we have a set of data, or a set of numbers in this case, and we want to organize our data and figure out what is the minimum, what is the median, what is the maximum, what is the mode, and what is the range. And some of these words you may have heard of, especially minimum and maximum. The other ones might be new. So let's first talk about what each of these mean. So the minimum is the smallest number. And you may know something that's mini is small. So the minimum is your smallest number. The other word you may have heard of is the maximum, which is the opposite. It's the largest or greatest number. And you probably know that the size between small and large is a medium, which is almost the same as a median, which is going to be for us the middle number. And it takes a little bit more time to figure out the median compared to the minimum or maximum, but we'll learn how to do that in a moment. Finally, the mode is our last M word, and this is the number that occurs the most often. And the last one here, the range, is the difference between the maximum and the minimum. So I'll just write that as max minus min. And I think these will make a lot more sense once we take a look at a set of data. Okay, so let's take a look at some real data and see if we can figure out these five values. And this here is some data I took on how many bicycles are at the houses of our students in our class. And I've already organized this into a T-chart with tally marks. Now, the easiest way to do this actually is to write out these numbers in order that they occurred. So you can see we had two zeros and one one, and then five twos, and then three threes, four, six fours, two fives, and a seven. So let me write the rest of that out. Okay, so there it is, and I have 20 numbers, and I know we have 20 students in our class, so that's the right data here. And now we can start to figure these out. So the minimum, the smallest number, zero bicycles. And the maximum was seven bicycles. Now we're going kind of out of order here, but we know the range is the maximum minus the minimum, which in this case is quite easy. Seven minus zero is going to give me seven for the range. Now the mode, which number happens the most? You can count, but actually my tally chart shows me four happens six times, so it's important the mode is going to be four, not six, but four, because it happened the most time, it occurred the most. So four is the mode. And to figure out the median, it takes a little bit more time than the other ones. I need to figure out what number is exactly in the middle. So to do that, I'm just going to cross off back and forth until I get to the middle number. And because we have 20, I know it's going to be two numbers in the middle. But back and forth. But it's the same number, so 3 is the median. And if you have two different numbers, then you'd have two medians. And you can also have two modes sometimes. So this is my set of data and the five values we were looking for. Now let's take a look at another set and see if you can figure it out. This is Lisa's data on how many teeth did you lose. So you can probably figure some out from looking at this, but remember your minimum is not one, because nobody lost one or two or three. Your minimum is going to be four, but let's just go ahead and write out the numbers to help us. So before I tell you, can you see what is the minimum and the maximum value? it would be 4 and 13. And to figure out the range then, you do some subtraction of the maximum minus the minimum. And hopefully you can do this, and you'll know that the range is going to be 9. The mode here, you can see both in the tally chart, this has the most. So there's your mode, you can see here, happens more than any other number. So your mode is 8. And finally for the median, we need to go back and forth to figure out the middle number. Let me finish that. And there you go, she had an odd number of numbers, 19, so the median number is going to be 8. Now you can also figure out this information just from a graph. So this is Miu's graph about how long have you been in Seisen, how many years have you been in our school, and see if you can just look at this graph here. This is the number of years, the number of students. So for the number of years, what's the minimum? What is the maximum? Then subtract those. What is the range and what is the mode? The number that occurs the most. Can you figure those out? Think for a moment. And here we can see the minimum is 1 and the maximum is 6. And the range is going to be 6 minus 1, which hopefully you know is 5. For the mode here, which one happens the most? 3 years is the most. And for the median, I think it's going to be 3, but let's just check again by going back and forth. I'm going to cross out three of these, here, here. And 3 is definitely going to be the middle number. So that's it. Hopefully you can remember what these math vocabulary words mean and use them to take a look at your own data and figure out the values for your own data that you've gathered. Thank you for watching.